In this section, we're going to be covering symbols. Now, symbols let you create copies of an object or design that all stay linked. So if you change one, all the others update automatically. So I've made this really boring company logo. I've just knocked this up, and we're going to turn this into a symbol. So how do we do that? Where's the symbols panel? Well, it's hidden by default, but if we just go up to Window and then go down to symbols, there it is. Just click on that. So now we've got the symbols panel open, and I just want to show you in the layers panel, here is our logo. It's just a group that contains two shapes. So I can select the group there, and then I can go ahead and click on create. So now we have the logo in the symbols panel. And if you look in the layers panel, it now has an orange strip on it that says symbol. So what can we do with this? Well, basically, now that it's a symbol, we can make copies of it. So I can either copy from here, so I could just hold Command, Shift, drag across a little bit, and now we can see we have a copy and it's also a symbol. Or I could just drag from the symbols panel, click and drag it out, let go, and now we have another copy. So we have three copies now. So if I just go in and I just double click so I can just get to this sun shape layer, if I go ahead and change the color of it, let's say I make it green, all the other duplicates are linked, so they all update automatically. So everything is looking exactly the same. Okay, cool. But what if we just wanted to change, let's say, the middle one? We want to change this to a different color. How do we do that without affecting everything else? Well, you just go on Synchronize here, and you just take that off, just toggle it off, and then you can make whatever change you want to make. Let's say you want to make it quite yellow. And then you can look in the layers panel, that layer that I just changed, it has this broken orange one, and that means it's not synced anymore. But if you did press sync again, and you went to change just this shape here, and you change the color of it, it would update across all of the rest of the design, but you just wouldn't be able to change this one and it be synced to the others, okay? So that's when you take sync off. Let's go to the last one, which is still fully synced. So if I change something here, you see it's still fully synced to the one on the left. So let's make it completely detached. We no longer want this group to be a symbol anymore. We could just go ahead and click on detach. So now it's completely detached. You see the layer in the layers panel. It no longer has that orange line on it. So any changes I make to it won't affect any of the other layers. And you can't really come back from this. If you want to make another duplicate, just drag in from the symbols layer, okay? So that's the basics of it and how it works. So let's just try it again so it beds in. So if you want to delete the symbol, just go in there and press delete symbol. Do I want to confirm to delete? Yes, I'll just delete all of these other options here. And I'll just take this one down into this artboard here. Okay, the real scenario. You've just designed the logo. You want to make it into a symbol so you can place it on here. So any future changes that you're asked to make will happen automatically. So with it selected, we'll select the group. We'll create the symbol. Excellent. Then we'll just drag that over to our other artboard and line it up. Excellent. You get a phone call. Hey, we don't like the green. We want it to be orange. Okay, no problem. I can do that. So just to be sure, you make a copy of this artboard. So you just hold Shift Command click and drag down. So you've got your copy now. And what you want to do now is just detach these ones just so they don't change. And now you'll concentrate on making this circle here orange. So you're going to go up and click on the orange one here. And now you've made it orange. Excellent. You send it off. They like it. Excellent. But then 2 weeks later, they come back and say, actually, we like the green. Well, you've already got it. So that's fine. Okay, let's switch to another document and we'll see what happens in the symbols panel. So I'm going to click another one that I have open here, and you can see the logo is completely gone. So obviously don't rely on that symbol to be there across multiple documents. So here we have a surfer. So I'm going to make a symbol out of that one. So I'm going to press create, and that's made it into a symbol. Now I'm just going to drag out a few copies of him. There we go. And let's say I want to change the t-shirt. Of course, we've done color before, haven't we? So I can do that because the sync is on, but also I can go in. And let's say, let's make the surfboard bigger maybe. So I can click on the surfboard and make it bigger like that. And it changes across all instances. So maybe he's on a really big surfboard now. And you could do that with pretty much anything there. I mean, I have plenty of layers. You can change things like the shorts, the hair even, you could make slightly bigger. Maybe he's a big hair surfer. And there we go, you can see it all. Let me turn off snapping. There we go. Look, he's bald and now he isn't. He's got loads of hair. So basically you can see what happens here. Actually could be quite useful for building up big crowds of people and just changing some of their t-shirt colors. Okay, that is the symbols panel.